rescue them that lost along the way for some reason or another. Amen?
Amen.
But as Jesus writes the letters to these seven churches of Asia Minor, each one of these letters either embrace a condemnation or a commendation. Amen, somebody. And, or it addressed approval or disapproval. Or it addressed loyalty or disloyalty. But all of these churches, amen, symbolize something as we look into the Word tonight. And of course, this is one of the education arms of your convention. And we thank God for Christian education. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But I want to look at this tonight. And if you just pray with me for a little bit, the door is still open. And I want to look at the importance of doors. Doors are important. Tell your neighbor, doors are important.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, doors and doorways are places of transition. Yeah, we move through them to get to the inside or to the outside. We move through them to get into another room or another state of being or another mode of existence. Doors can hide or they can reveal. I remember a country song, amen, called When We Get Behind. Come on, I got some country folks in here. Yeah, the gentleman, the singer said that, it helps men to know, help him to realize that he is a real man. Hallelujah, somebody. So doors can hide or they can reveal. Remember, Teddy Pendergrass had one called Close. Y'all act like y'all didn't say that. We're going to keep it real tonight. You have not forgotten. And sometimes when you get in the right mood, you will sing it right now. Let's get in the right, amen, the right posture, and you want to hear a little bit of Teddy, don't you? Come on, somebody, and come closer. I'm going to say it for you. Hallelujah, somebody. So doors can hide or they can reveal. They can include and they can exclude. Doors can encourage and they can discourage. It all depends upon whether the door is closed or open. Ever got some help in here? Some of you, baby boomers and those folk who are before us baby boomers, remember when we had doors closed against us. Ever got somebody? Yes, certain restaurants, the doors closed. Certain movie theaters, the doors were closed. Come on, somebody. Yeah. Because of segregation. Yeah, there were certain places that you could not go into because the door. Help me in here with you. And it hadn't been that long, and if you keep messing around with 45, y'all gonna get it out of mind. As he's trying to close every door that's been open. Have I got some help in here? I'm just talking about what I'm talking about. Amen, somebody. So doors, amen, if they're closed against you, if you're not careful, can be discouraging. And that's why you can never give up hope when it comes down to the gospel of Jesus Christ. Because I've discovered that with God, all things are possible. Close one door, he'll open another door. Have I got somebody in here? Set me out over here, he'll open up a way over there. Have I got somebody? And so I want to encourage somebody tonight with some good news. Amen. Amen. Remind you that the door is still open. Jesus opened the door over 2,000 years ago, and the invitation still stands. Have I got any help in here? He said, whosoever will, let him together. You just come. Hallelujah, somebody. Hallelujah, because, hallelujah, sick folk don't need to go to the hospital. Amen. I'm sorry. Well folk don't need to go to the hospital. They don't need a hospital. But sick folk need to come on just like they are. Hallelujah, somebody. And so the door is still open. What I want to do tonight is just remind you that no matter what door you may have missed along the way, amen, I want to remind you that it's still open. Hallelujah, somebody. Whatever your unrealized dreams or your aspiration, whatever unfulfilled hopes or plans that you had in the past, the door is still open. Maybe you had good big plans for ministry, but something happened along the way and you felt like the door was shut against you. And you know, church folk will do that sometimes. But I want to remind you that you always have access to the kingdom of God. Amen. Jesus has the authority because when he got up just a few days ago, he said, I got all power in my hand. And so we have to understand how that works for us. Hallelujah, somebody. And understand that God is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. And so here we are, amen, again in our School of Christian Education. And as we study in the Word, and we have, again, different officers and offices and choir members and ushers and deacons and ministry leaders. Am I right? Am I right about that? Yeah, we have all the positions that are in the church, and everybody needs some Christian education. Have you got any help now? The day has passed and gone when folk just give you, say, well, baby, all you need is a black skirt and a white blouse, and you can be an usher. You need to know how to be an usher. Hallelujah, somebody. The day has passed and gone when, you just, all you need to do is learn a hymn and wail on it. Amen. And you can be a deacon. No, you need to know a little something. Come on. Hallelujah. And the good thing about it is the door is still open. Amen. Just because you look like a leader does not make you out of it. Y'all ain't going to have to be there. See, I'm getting in trouble already. Amen. But the first thing I want to look at in the text tonight, amen, because as Christ commends the church at Philadelphia, and I love this, amen, he praises them because they resulted from their faithfulness to him. And it's good when we are faithful unto God. Yeah, and especially those of us that are in ministry, no matter what the capacity is, it requires faithfulness. Yeah, it does not. I didn't say slothfulness now. I said faithfulness. Say amen if you can. And so the first thing I'm looking at in the text is, amen, the church at Philadelphia was commended because they understood the scope of the word. Somebody said the scope of the word. Yeah, how far reaching it was, the range and the scale and the span of the word, how it ranked over everything else when we look at Jesus as being the door. Amen, somebody. And so faithfulness gets us the promised rewards of God. Yeah, you've got to be faithful. You can't expect God, because God's blessings also have some conditions that go along with it. There's some folk that want the anointing that somebody else has, but you're not faithful. You show up every now and then. You drag in the name that you, when you get that, you don't have no enthusiasm about what God has called you to do. It does not matter what capacity you may be serving in. You ought to be faithful to whatever God has called you to do. You gotta be faithful. Hallelujah, somebody. Yeah, you can't just be name only, but you are David Wright saying you got to practice what you preach. Is there going to be some help in this house tonight? And so if you're going to experience the blessings of God, it's going to require some sacrifice. It's going to require some faithfulness. And sacrifice means that, you know what, I got to kill my flesh. I got to kill some things that I might want to do. I got to give up some of my time to give it to God. Ain't nobody else. Run on our schedule. It's got to be run on God's schedule. Not when I have an opportunity, but you ought to make an opportunity to serve the Lord with gladness. Hallelujah. And Jesus opened the door, he says, amen. And in fact, he says, I am the door. And if any man comes after me, yet if any man enter in, he shall be saved. Yet shall go in and out and find pastors. Y'all still with me? He said, I come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. Tell somebody, he wants you to live large. He wants you to do big things, great things in your ministry. It does not matter whether you're an usher, deacon. It does not matter what capacity you serve in. He wants you to do great things. He wants you to do abundant things in whatever capacity that he has called you to.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. I remember some time back, hallelujah, there were some deacons who would always wait outside under the tree until the rest of the deacons get done with their devotion. I forgot some help out there. They lag around. Y'all don't want to help me now, right? Yeah, I just thought I'd drop that on you. Amen, somebody. But you got to be a willing vessel. Hallelujah, somebody. And so the good thing is the door is still open. If you're going to be productive in ministry, that means that requires that you be faithful in whatever he wants you to do. And so you've got to understand the scope of the word. And in this word, this door, through this door, is fruitfulness and it's abundance, it's victory, it's success, it's direction, it's riches, it's honor, it's dominion, it's hallelujah, somebody, it's protection. But you've got to be faithful. And when you're faithful over a few things, then God will bless you with more. We got anybody in here? And so the first thing we look at is the scope of the word. It was a great opportunity for all of us. Anybody who is walking with Christ has a great opportunity, amen, to do great things for him. Hallelujah, somebody. And I like that because God favors those who love him and that are faithful to him. God has a plan for you, hallelujah, for your life. He has a purpose for you and for your destiny, hallelujah, somebody. And God will provide whatever you need. That's why he's Jehovah Jireh, hallelujah, somebody. Yeah, he has a plan for you, and that's why the door is open. Amen, somebody. And so the truth of the matter is, we cannot be like some of the folk that were part of the churches of Asia Minor. Church of Ephesus, amen, they lost their first love. Y'all remember that, right? Y'all remember that from Bible study. And if God has called you, I got to repeat it again, whatever he called you for, you ought to keep on loving it. You can't lose your first love. If you were on fire when God called you, when he saved you, you ought to still be on fire. You ought not lose your zeal because somebody talked about you and somebody didn't call your name. Yeah, they didn't recognize you and they saw me sitting up here. And all that. You ought not lose your zeal. Can I say it like this? is over what Negroes think about you. And I know about what I'm talking about. Some folks lose their zeal. They leave their first love because somebody said something about them that they didn't like. In fact, they didn't hear them say it. Somebody told you that they said something about you. You don't know whether they said it or not.
Separate me
from the love of God. Yeah, he opened this door for me, not anybody else. Hallelujah, somebody. So don't lose your first love. You got to stay on fire. You got to keep the fire burning. You got to keep your zeal going. Hallelujah, somebody. Don't be like the church at Pergamos. Pergamos was a compromising church. You got a lot of believers that are compromising. Ever got anybody in here, y'all? Y'all don't want to help me right there, do you? If anybody else is doing it, then I'm all right. Huh? Hallelujah. But if the moment they go to the left, yeah, I'm going to forget all about what my ministry is all about. I forget all about what my assignment is. Am I talking too much up here? Huh? Pergamos was a compromising church. Instead of staying on assignment, they would go with the status quo. I wish I had time to walk in every one of them tonight, but they were a compromising church. You got folk that are in ministry that are compromising folk. And my folk, homies, my neighbors, my brothers, my sisters, are staying home to watch Empire. I'm going to stay home too. They're going to stay home to watch, amen, somebody. The Browns are scandalous. I ain't going out there. Ain't nobody else. I'm on the wrong street. I'm in the wrong place. Hallelujah, somebody. Compromising. And for the sake of, instead of the gospel. Hallelujah, somebody. When you ought to do all you can. In the name of the Lord. And then Thyatira was a corrupt church. We ain't got no corrupt folk in here. Y'all don't want me to elaborate on that one. But in some churches, not this one, not greater, not all the churches represented here tonight, they are not here tonight. But there are some corrupt folk. Nothing is ever right for them. Are y'all still in here? They do not see the open door and how great of opportunity that they have to be in the gospel. I feel a little sweat now. Hallelujah, somebody. So you cannot be a corrupt person in ministry because God has called us for the ministry of reconciliation. How are you going to draw somebody? See, it's not just the preachers, not just the deacons. It's everybody. Everybody is a witness for the Lord. I got some help in here. And if you corrupt, how are you going to witness to Ray Ray and Nene Boo and all of them at the house? I know I wasn't going to get that. Hallelujah, somebody. Yeah, you got to be careful with that. And then Sardis was a dead church. I got some folk in ministry, you have to wave them and see if they're alive. Bless the Lord, boy. You think they dead, man. Now, we got some help in here. Sardis was a dead church. That's misrepresenting the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Our God is a living God. He is very much alive. And when you saw him, you ought to be alive. Laodicea was a lukewarm man. You know, it's bad. Especially if you're a ministry leader and you're lukewarm. Come on, help me in here. Hallelujah, somebody. Yeah, it's okay if we do and it's okay if we don't. Now, y'all just come on. Y'all, I'm going to leave y'all alone, man. Hallelujah, somebody. But you've got to be ready for ministry. Have I got some help in here? And sometimes that means that you got to get out of your comfort zone. Yeah, see, some folk, the enemy will dare you to get out of your comfort zone. As long as you lay back and you're not trying to do anything, it ain't gonna bother you. But I dare you to step it up. I dare you that, amen, just get on hallelujah fire for the Lord and watch how the enemy get on your trail. Hallelujah, somebody. That's why he opened the door so that you can do wondrous things in the kingdom. Hallelujah. That's a window. Let me share this window. It says, what's more humiliating than to feel you've missed the plum for the lack of courage to shake the tree? Hallelujah. If you want to be a better teacher, a better preacher, a better pastor, a better youth leader, a better superintendent, a better choir member, a better usher, whatever your capacity is, a better superintendent, a better Sunday school teacher, you got to shake the tree. Yeah, y'all still in it with me? Guess what? Because everybody's not going to like it no how. Huh? Tell somebody you got to shake the tree. The door is still open. Tree shakers are people who act on the word of God. But they are not perfect, but they strive to defy the enemy and bless the Lord. Tree shakers are people who will be ridiculed for acting on the word of God, and yet God will bless you for standing on the promises of God. Our tree shakers will be rejected by the in crowd. You know, some every church has an in crowd. Every minister has an in crowd. And when you come in on fire, they'll try to pour water on you. Have I got somebody in here? Yeah, the in crowd. They poke fun at you, say ugly things behind your back, but don't worry about them. Hallelujah, somebody. You got to learn how to risk it all for Christ. And sometimes it means going out on a limb and say, for God I'll live and for God I'll die. Hallelujah, somebody. Yeah, tree shakers. Yeah, say, they're just like what Paul says, not as though I've already attained. Either where I already perfected, but I follow after, if I may apprehend that which Christ also apprehended. Hallelujah. I count myself, hallelujah, somebody, not to have apprehended, but this one thing. I'm not perfect. But there's one thing I do. I forget those things that are behind me. And I'm reaching. Look at somebody tell me you got to reach for it. Sometimes that means going out on a limb. Sometimes we got to reach for a little bit. Folks ain't going out there. And see, some folk are lazy and they want to stay in their comfort zone. And the moment you start trying to get them out on the limb, they'll start talking about you. And say, I ain't going to be doing all of that right there. They must be crazy. We done tried that back in 1934. It didn't work then. Well, tell somebody it's a new day. And tell them it's a new people. And we are all about the kingdom of God. And you got to be willing to set the trend.
For the prize. Yeah. See, because I know who I'm running for. Yeah. I know who I'm in ministry for. It's not about you. It's not about me. It's about him. It's about JC. Come on, somebody. Tell him it's about JC. Tell him it's not about you. It's not about me, but it's about JC. Hallelujah. And I'm running. Bring stuff off the street. Somebody who they didn't like on the street. And they show up in church. Hallelujah. Now you can't worship right. You got to forget those things that are behind you. And press for the mark. Secondly, I'm about to close. Amen. But second thing is, yeah, the church at Philadelphia not only saw the scope of the word, the scope of the opportunity, but they understood the stewardship of the word. James says that you got to be a doer of the word. Hallelujah, somebody. And Paul said it like this in 1 Corinthians 16, verse 9. He said, a great door and effectual is open unto me. And there are many adversaries. Yes. Can I help somebody in here? Yes. When God opens doors for you, yes, when you start to be a steward of the word of God, yes, that's why it's good to go to Bible study. Yes. That's why it's good to go to Sunday school. That's why it's good to come to School of Christian Education meetings. That's why it's good to go to the institutes. Ain't nobody saying nothing on this side of the house. I'm going to preach on this side of the house. That's why it's good to get some learning. Amen. For your burden. Come on, somebody. Yeah, you ought to know what it's all about so that you can do all that you can in the name of the Lord. James said, you know, you got to be doers of the word. Hallelujah. There are some people, they know the word, but they don't do nothing with it. They can quote it upside down, sideways. They can stand on their head and quote it. Have I got somebody in here? But they don't do anything with it. But the church at Philadelphia had some ministry folks that was all about the kingdom. Some help in the house. Yeah. Yeah, they were a live church. And you know, your reaction to the word of God determines the working of the word of God in your life. You got to apply the word. Hallelujah. They were full of life. And where the spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. They had liberty in their healings. They had liberty in their financial blessings. They had liberty in deliverance. They had a liberty in all that they did because they were striving to be the best that they could in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. I use this all the time. Yet most times when folk are trying to perfect their craft, then they try to find out everything they can about it. They don't have a better new spirit. Have I got something? Yeah, that'll do it, you know. But you ought to be one of new. But you remember when you used to go to the club? And when a new dance came out, you didn't want to hit the floor until you learned every move. In fact, you'll get called somebody over to help you learn how to move. Y'all did it. Y'all might as well help you there. I know all y'all were in the wallflowers. Some of y'all learned them new steps too. Hallelujah, somebody. You wanted to do the best. You wanted, when you hit the floor, you know, you want to be able to say, I got this. If I got something, y'all ain't helping me, y'all ain't never done that before, y'all ain't. Amen, somebody. And you know, maybe when Drop It Like It Hot came around, you was too old to drop it. And you didn't talk about it over, but if you had been in that era. Don't look at me in that tone of voice. Don't look at me. Hallelujah, somebody. You wanted to do it just right. Hallelujah, somebody. And so what's wrong with the church? Why don't you strive like that for the church? Can I just go just one more little bit more and then I'm gonna be done. Amen. And most of us had to get our nerves built up. Y'all know where I'm going now, don't you? We had to get our spirits right. They trying to be quiet over here, right over here. Amen, somebody. But you start grooming before 11 o'clock. You want to be in the spirit when you get in the place. Come on, y'all. I'm going to just keep it real because I'm finna close. I'm going to keep it real. Yeah, you're going to be, you have your little, amen, some mighty head, and you're sipping to get it just right. So when you go in, you are in the right mood. What's wrong with the church? What's wrong with priming yourself up with the Holy Ghost? Y'all see that? What's wrong with having a prayer vision and reading some scriptures? What's wrong with giving yourself in the right spirit before you show up to do ministry in church? What's wrong? Spirits. Yeah, you used to have that other spirit that got you ready, but now when you show up for the kingdom agenda, you ought to have the spirit of God moving, and everything moves by the spirit of God. You ought to have him out in front of you saying, let's go, baby. It's time to do ministry. It's time to do church. And I'm ready for whatever. Hallelujah, somebody. You want to do it in the spirit. Hallelujah, somebody. Because you have the authority to do what God wants you to do. But all you got to do is learn how to walk in the spirit. Have I got some help in here? Now, I'm not talking about that other spirit where you took one step forward and three steps back, but I'm talking about walking in the Holy Ghost. Have I got some help in here? Somebody in here knows what I'm talking about. When you learn how to lean and depend on Jesus, is there anybody here know that he will make a way for you? And tell them I want to be a good steward in the name of the Lord. And one thing I've discovered is, since the door is still open, I'm going to do all I can in the name of the Lord. And I'm not going to allow discouragement.
judgment to set me down. I'm not gonna allow adversity to set me down. I'm not gonna allow criticism to set me down, because I found out that only what you do for Christ is going to last. Just remind your neighbor just one more time, as I find my way to my seat. But thank you, David, for reminding me that the word is another door. In Psalm 119 and verse 130, I hear the Spirit say, the entrance into that word gives light. Just tell somebody, when you open your Bible, when you say your prayers, when you go to Bible study, when you go to Sunday school, he gives you more light. That's an open door in your life. I find somebody, I thank God for my opportunity. Hallelujah. This door of opportunity enlarges my understanding. This door, is there anybody in here? Give me more wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. This door, hallelujah, of opportunity helps me to follow my way through. I give credence, hallelujah, to what the psalmist said, that the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. I'm glad, I said I'm glad, that Jesus knew that the door was closed against us. I'm glad that one Friday, anybody know one Friday, as he made his way up Via Dolorosa, one Friday, as he carried your sin and my sin up Calvary's Hill, anybody here know that he died? Yeah. is on the sparrow. And I know, come what may, He watches over me. Hallelujah. Just a moment, I want to open the door still open.